In this work, the mechanical behavior of cementitious mortar with the short fibers used for FRCM composites is experimentally investigated by comparing results from direct tensile and triple bending tests. The final aim of the work is the analysis of the tension softening behavior of this material. As concerned direct tensile tests, 17 dog bone specimens are cast. A digitally controlled instrument machine is used by adopting a clevis grip. Displacement and strain field are analyzed through DIC technique. Dog bone specimen shape determines the development of cracking within the central zone immediately after the reaching of mortar tensile strength. The obtained stress versus crack opening curves can be used for the calibration of a tension softening load for finite element analysis. By considering the cracking loads, a mean value of tensile strength is provided. It can be observed that this kind of direct tensile test seems promising also for cementitious mortars, even if it requires special cares to avoid bending, scatter results, and anomalous crack formation. For triple bending tests, prismatic samples are used with a central notch in order to localize the crack within the knife edges of the clip gauge that controls the test. The crack starts from the beam notch and gradually develops thanks to the bridging action of fibers. The evolution of crack path is also analyzed through DIC image elaboration in terms of horizontal strains. Three-point bending test execution is easier and allows providing less dispersed results in terms of flexural tensile strength. Thanks to DIC technique, it is also possible to assess the initial cracking load and the axial tensile strength by observing the actual cracking onset. However, the results depend on image resolution and frequency of photo acquisition. A correlation factor between axial and flexural tensile strength is proposed and compared to the one suggested in Model Code 2010 for normal strength concrete, which seems to be applicable also for the analyzed cementitious mortars.